Exactly. A crime alert tonight about your passport. It's your ticket to traveling abroad, but privacy advocates are worried it could be a crook's key to stealing your personal information. New at 11, Aaron Gilchrist has more in a special edition of the Ripoff Report.
New passports use what's called radio frequency identification, or RFID technology, to add a layer of security for international travelers. But as with most new technologies, crooks have figured out a way to access information you don't want them to have.
It is literally your key to getting into and out of the country. And as of August 2007, the State Department only issues passports with a small chip embedded in the back cover. Everything printed on your passport is in that chip.
Soon after the U.S. government started putting these RFID chips into individual passports, there were a number of thieves and a number of individuals out there that said, hey, we can gather this information with just using a laptop and a wireless connection.
In some cases, the RFID technology is that simple. If you're in a crowded room and someone has configured a powerful RFID reader, your information is compromised in just a keystroke.
There's a wound wire, basically it's like an antenna inside here.
TJ Iden runs an electronic security business in Chesterfield. He says similar RFID technology is used in credit cards and access cards and by businesses trying to protect property and products. It's a small chip with endless possibilities.
Anything from a picture or a fingerprint, or in the case of a passport or something like that, it can save your passport number, your image, where you've been.
The State Department was inundated with complaints when it announced a transition to electronic passports and got to work safeguarding them. It added RF blocking material to passport covers. It has to be physically opened to be read. Passports also contain encrypted codes that only authorized readers can crack. The State Department has also taken steps to prevent tracking and copying of passports. Still, it admits nothing is foolproof.
The Stronghold bag is made up of numerous metals, nickel, copper, and a number of other composite of metals that are all woven together.
Our private investigator recommends a device like this for added protection for things with RFID. You can insert a passport, credit card, or the access card for your office building or your child's daycare center into a bag like this.
By sealing it up, it no longer allows the passport to transmit that signal, therefore the individuals that are around you that are trying to obtain your information can no longer get access to it.
Some RFID readers will work as far as 30 feet away from the target, but with passports and credit cards, the encryption is so intricate, a criminal would be hard-pressed to even figure out whatever information they could possibly get from those cards. I'm Aaron Gilchrist, NBC 12 News.